Well, hello everybody. Welcome back to Wiz Hitman with your host, Wizware 100, and...
And Hitman.
Yes. What do you know? It's been a while, but we're finally back with a video to commentate on a game that we've been playing.
We're going through an airport terminal.
Yes, the game is Jazz Punk, a game that I think I picked up from a Humble Bundle.
And I saw one of the streamers I watch playing this, but I didn't... Okay, that's a new thing.
You didn't like watch it all the way through, right?
No, I didn't watch any of the game.
Okay, then that's perfect, cause this game is kind of like a little bit of a point and adventure game, although it's very
right.
light. It's a point and click adventure game sort of, cause you move around. There's a little bit of light puzzle solving, and it's kind of like quirky and goofy sort of. I didn't show everything in this game, cause I didn't want to spoil everything, and plus it would take a little longer to play this game, and this intro is so long.
Yeah, it's true. I can imagine this is like, I could have read that if they kept it on for much further.
Yes, because you've been learning Japanese language.
I have learned all I will ever learn because don't my school requirements. But the one thing earlier, there was a green sign and it said concourse.
Oh, really?
Man, this ship's gonna crash in the Hudson River.
And well,
you see that? It sucked a bunch of birds through it.
Yeah, a bunch of pigeons. I was originally gonna say, like, cause some of those texts are actually Chinese, but like it's Japanese, cause they also still use some of the Chinese text too.
Yeah, Chinese characters or kanji
as they say it. Yeah, so a funny thing an unfortunate thing that happened with this is that first time I recorded this, the audio didn't get recorded, so I got really annoyed with it. But
yeah.
Fortunately, this game is not that long, so it was okay.
So what kind of punk is particularly into jazz?
A jazz punk. So we're playing this character called Polly Blank, and he does missions for this guy called the Director. This game is very short, by the way.
I'm just a box, leave me alone.
Yeah, that box talks.
So is it like, or is it just things that talk? Like, does text appear around things whenever you talk to them?
It's kind of like when you enter into the Matrix, sort of. You need jobs in the Matrix. You remember Johnny Mnemonic? It's kind of, it's sort of
yeah.
something like that. Because you jump into the, like, some sort of cyber internet.
So instead
world.
Of instead of downloading things onto your brain, you download your
brain
onto things?
You go into, like, the simulation.
Business to discuss.
That's the director right there.
And he put a whoopee cushion on your...
Yes, and you had no choice but to do that.
Excellent.
Oh, by the way, if you know who Jim Sterling is, he's in this game. I don't know which voice actor or which voice he is in this game, though.
So is he just going to be like this guy? Go...
He actually is saying something to you, but there's the text just to, like, get the main idea.
Oh, okay.
Like the very important stuff, not like all the extra flavor.
Okay, because when he said I'll be in the wine cellar, he fell asleep. Okay,
he
but when
went,
he said he was when he said he was going to be in the wine cellar, I could kind of make out the words.
He went down into the, cellar, but it was like really he just went down to sleep.
It's a figurative wine cellar.
Jazz punk.
He just likes to imagine it.
Yeah,
it's
so
like, it'd be like, oh, I'm going to my wine cellar, and then you just go to the fridge and bought a bottle of wine.
Yeah, something like that. So. There's only like three missions in this game, but it's kind of like the selling point of the game is how quirky it is. There's a lot of stuff to do in this first world, by the way, and I've done most of them, but I decided not to show it in this this playthrough for our commentary, or else we'd be here for hours because it took me like 3 hours to like play through and look at everything.
It did not even. What? Did you just jump on that guy?
No, I just pushed him. I just pushed him out of the way, and he's dead now.
Oh really? He fell.
Yeah.
What an asshole.
And there's...
Is this some kind of cyberspace world?
Yes, yes. Or, I'm pretty sure, because you took the pills to, like, jump into the Matrix, and if you looked at the trailer, he pretty much jumped into the Matrix.
Yeah.
I'm afraid you don't have appointment.
I'm afraid you don't have appointment. I am lady with green lipsticks. I swear she didn't have green lipsticks the first time I played it. So,
security clearance.
So here's, like, the little
so
puzzle.
So we got a pretty clear puzzle.
Yeah, but it's not that difficult. The only difficult part was, like, knowing where all the pieces were. So
oh my god, your hand is fucked up.
Yeah, so the puzzle here is to go through it through the window, but I didn't know about that clock there, so I was like, where the fuck is everything?
Wait,
and so I had to use the hint line.
You just move the hands of the clock?
Yeah, it's just literally a hand that you pick up.
So you just ate a sandwich?
Yep, I just took a sandwich. And they talk about stuff.
It's got one of those weird indie sensibilities. Of course, I can't read what they're talking about. It's like, how's the wife? This is how's the wife? I ain't
married, you boob. It's backwards.
I'm not married. The player won't notice. You think we should leave that running? Oh, whatever.
Yeah, so they just started talking something goofy, and I never looked at this before, so I thought I'd show, like, a bit of its quirkiness. I do play some of this other stuff in this game, too. Oh, yeah. There's a random event where, like, an agent comes up and talks to you and says, why don't you go look around the city? But it didn't happen here, though a similar event happens later on, though.
Right.
So now we're going here, and then something silly happens.
What, he just strike a pose?
Do-do-do-do!
God.
Oh yeah, those microscopes, one of them has a video- Space Invaders. It has a minigame in there, it's just kind of like, oh look, reference!
So this is what they're doing at those chemistry labs. You know, I always wondered.
Looking through the scope, maybe they're looking so far in the microscopes of life that they actually saw, like, the original, like, Space Invaders. Like, it was, like, an atom size.
That's what cells do for fun. They sort of, like, they, you know, like how we do Civil War reenactments? Like, they do, like, Space Invaders reenactments?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how the first cell got on Earth, true story.
So the tape is in here, and we gotta steal it. But it requires that, and we gotta get some Comrade Crunch. Obviously a parody of Captain Crunch.
That's excellent. You know something like that exists in Russia, or existed in Russia, like the cheap knockoff of something, but with communism added onto it.
Oh yeah, check this phone out. Like, a few weird things happen, so I let it play out.
Huh. Quit here.
Like, there's a few numbers you can dial on here that will do something, like, quirky or funny.
Adult pay-per-view.
Dial 3 for the Kremlins. From Donkey Kong Country?
No, the Kremlin's the center of intelligence for the Soviet Union.
Oh, really? And then you can dial 666 for Satan.
Nice. But yeah, you know what that reminds me of? The Comrade Crunch. It reminds me of this knockoff of Team Fortress 2 that the Chinese are making.
Oh, yeah.
Did you see that?
You mean Halve? That's Korea.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was Korea.
Yeah, because I remember that they literally just made Team Fortress 2.
But with, like, anime-ish girls.
Yeah, I mean, no, that was actually different. No, in China, they made, like, a legit carbon copy of TF2.
Oh, okay, then. We have to look at that later. So there's the tape. I don't know why picking up in the virtual world counts, but this should have made more sense, so I did the more sensible way. So now we gotta
I guess interacting with that thing is what made it dispense the tape.
Yep. Well, with the phone, you dialed 1 to, like... Because the phone was like, hey, thanks for hacking. So there's a ID
thing.
Does
that say Neocortex? Are we in Crash Bandicoot right now?
Oh, really? Anyways, we gotta get out of the place, and there's an eye scanner. You could use the photo there, but you can also scan your butt and use the pictures of the butt. I'm gonna let the
classic
computer...
office tactics.
Wait, listen to this.
Welcome back, Dr. Buttley.
Oh my god.
Welcome back, Dr. Buttley. Oh, and here's a reference for those playing N64 games.
That's GoldenEye, isn't it?
Yep. That's it. And the floor was slippery, so I slipped. Or it was lubricated.
Speaking of N64 first-person shooter games, do you ever play Perfect Dark?
Yeah, I played a bit of it.
Because I got the game, but apparently you need, like, an expansion pack or something to actually get the main game.
Game to work.
Yeah, because I played it and it was just an arena game, and I was like, this isn't fun.
Yeah, because it couldn't handle all the stuff. So that was the mission. But obviously, you were supposed to explore the entire map for stuff, but I didn't do that for the sake of this video.
Right.
So now we gotta go steal this guy's kidney in a very Japanese place. His kidney.
Are you here to steal his kidney? A kidney is worth $25 million. That's pretty good.
It's because his kidney is an artificial one.
Right.
And I like this mission. This mission is very quirky. He says improvise, but you don't really improvise in the sense of actually having the freedom to improvise. I still have that breadcrumb from that simulation.
That is a pretty original thing. I've never been told to steal someone's kidney in a video game before.
Unless you're a black markets person.
Well, actually, you know, maybe that one mission in GTA 4 counts. Remember that mission where you you have to get rid of people's bodies by selling them to a organ salesman?
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, it was called Have a Heart.
Oh yeah, a lot of the people here, like, the characters say Japanese things.
Miso sphincter.
Vomit. And then, what's this we drink?
Pigeon milk?
Oh, I can't even begin to imagine.
Pigeon milk?
I just like that he vomits it on people. I don't even know what that third one is like.
Funky water?
Okay, I know what it was, but I was like, what color is that?
I have been shamed.
Yeah, so I show off more of the quirky stuff here, because it's a lot quicker and more straightforward.
Yeah. You know, I've been shamed, I think, is the single most common phrase in the Japanese language. True story.
Yes, they are. Oh, this one is really, funny if you're a computer dork. Like, at one point, she mentioned something about the kimono. I found that really funny, because, mono and stereo.
Yeah.
Okay, so
she's looping now.
Yeah, so that's why I went. That hobo was pissing.
Getting a robo-hobo?
Hobo people, like, they really need to just, like, really need to get off of people, other people's lives, because they're really intrusive, I find.
Robo-hobos?
Oh.
Yeah, an unemployed robot would be pretty dangerous.
How does a robot unemployed? Anyway, so I go into the shop to smash, or kill flies, but I end up smashing all the pots.
Yeah, this I've seen, actually.
There's actually a Steam achievement for breaking all the pots here. It was okay. Because I thought if you, broke as little pots as possible, it might do something good or change the dialogue where the lady's like, oh, thank you for not breaking all the pots, but nope, she just has the same reaction, just break all the pots.
This is the Spec Ops The Line scenario where, you kind of feel like if you'd done nothing, it would have been better.
Well, the purpose of the vases here is so the flies actually fly into them to actually be able to hit them easier, but if you destroy all of them, they just keep flying all over the place.
Right.
I also picked up... The other reason I came into this place is to pick up this fly swatter.
Is it like fly larvae in no. there, or what?
No, those are brains. I don't know why, but...
Yeah, I don't know... Man, it's organ trafficking all over the place in Japan.
Yeah.
Can you smack her in the face with them?
Yes, watch.
Okay. I'm not that kind of girl.
Kind of the talking about the SMN part of Japan.
She reverses. Okay, it's just like, I don't like this. I'm starting to enjoy
Look
this.
At that.
Yeah,
that guy
I actually
flying.
Really like this.
Oh, here's the other box. There's four boxes you talk to get one of the.
There's just flies everywhere.
I don't know why, but it's just...
Secret fly world order.
It's just goofy. Oh yeah, there's also the video rental things that you can return.
You are not professional.
Fly swatter.
You are not professional swatter. That's a good one.
Oh yeah, here... That pizza there leads to a little mini game. That guy has ears, and I didn't notice his cotton swab the first time, and...
You have to cotton swab his...
Yep, and then you get a brain sandwich.
A sandwich?
Yeah, I didn't notice it...
Thought.
I didn't notice it the first time. It only took me until a second playthrough when I was recording that I was like, oh, so that's the significance. So I play the Evil Dead pizza. I think that's what this reference was.
You know, that's pretty clever. I can imagine that actually having been used in an intelligence agency once.
Oh,
yeah,
like,
there's this random pizza box lying. It's actually a laptop computer.
Oh yeah. I can't. This almost looks like a Pizza Hut place, but I can't tell if it's a reference to Evil Dead or whatever. Or what?
I don't know. That looks Pizza Hut-ish, like the red roof.
Yeah, I tried to go into the door, but you have to kill these guys to have the door open, and you can't die, as far as I'm concerned.
Are they garlic bread men or
pizza men?
I guess they kind of look like pizza.
I mean, they got cheese and meat sauce all over them. They're like Freddy Krueger.
I don't know. They're just kind of like. Makes pizza, okay.
Like, is this not Evil Dead setting?
Well, that was The Shining right there.
Oh, really?
Hey, you ever see The Shining?
Oh, I saw that part of it. Oh, the writing part, okay.
Yeah, in The Shining, what was his name? The Jack Torrance, Jack Nicholson, was just writing the same thing over and over again.
Yeah. Okay, so I just show off the hint line, even though I know what to do, but it's kind of neat they have this little hint line to help you with, just to progress in the game.
Yeah.
So now we gotta go into the restaurant, but I'm just like dicking around a little.
I can see why this video turned out short. You're just like zooming through things.
Yeah, because
it doesn't even react.
Nope. This restaurant, I like this restaurant. It's funny. Or the stuff I do.
Yoshimasu.
Shoo off.
That just sounds bad. This reminds me of a Ghost in the Shell. You ever watch that?
Oh no, I haven't.
Ghost in the Shell standalone complex. Their first mission in the show is there's like a bunch of robo geishas that have gone rogue from a restaurant.
Yeah.
Yeah, like robot geishas. And I'm like, at some random Japanese restaurant. I'm like, what were these used for?
Anyway, so now we're collecting spiders because the lady asked us, but it does have a use for it. There's actually 8 spiders in the restaurant, and this video has a small part where I'm actually showing you where all the spiders are.
Yeah.
But yeah,
So can you, like, use them for something?
Oh, you'll see.
Alright.
Because, you'll see later on. Because
this would be a great way for a restaurant to outsource its, pest control problems. It's like, catch five spiders, get a free appetizer.
Oh, that'd be kind of neat. But then wouldn't the
pest... You'd have to make it infested with pests in the first place.
Well, but wouldn't it also, like pest control would be like, hey, you can't open your restaurant because it's really dirty and people could get sick. So that's all 8 spiders.
Yeah, but I don't know.
All right, so this is what you'd use with the spiders. I will be your dedicated and her dedication spider. Is not being dedicated. I am terrified of spiders. Oh, that was fast. So this guy was kind of an asshole to me, if you actually tried to talk to him.
You may not enter because I have arachnophobia, but the spiders are out here.
This place is filled with spiders. He speaks Japanese on occasion.
I am not a fly.
I like how the one guy's reaction, by the way, to your swatter technique was just like, you are not a professional.
This one says it too.
Oh, jeez.
And then, like, I try to help him.
Tell him by swatting the spider.
But it does nothing.
Against his face.
Okay, so the cowboy guy.
Professional video recording right there. You
have yes, yes.
Fugu technique. Does he have a puff of the fish?
He insulted me, so I poisoned and blinded him. Anyways, the cowboy guy is in this, what was it? This restaurant, so.
Yeah, I saw him.
So we gotta, like, get his
kidney.
Squirt
Fugu fish onto him?
Yes. Fugu fish poison.
I wonder who was the first person to decide, hey, this poisonous sea creature, let's eat it.
The Japanese.
And let's keep some of the poison in.
Actually, they don't do that. And the
I thought they did. I thought it was like there was a trick to preparing it where you have to like use the poison for flavor, but don't make it enough to
be lethal.
Not to be lethal, yeah.
Oh, that's kind of a little messed up, I gotta say.
Yeah, but... you see, there's all kinds of references in this guy, too. Johnny Cash.
Yeah, isn't this, like, one of the president, like, I did not have sexual relationship with that woman.
Bill Clinton? I don't think this looks like Bill Clinton. Dude's got a cowboy hat. If anything, it's W.
Oh, well, okay. It had to be some American guy. I knew that.
Might be just your traditional, American cowboy stereotype. Do you have to talk to this guy, or...?
No, but he said this one piece of dialogue that I wanted to, like... Yeah, there we go. The Fugu. I wonder what I should do with the Fugu.
This would be a great first-person shooter. Would that be a great idea for first-person shooter?
Oh, just wait till later on, you'll see something like that. So I Fugu'd one of the sushi dishes like nobody noticed it, and guess which one he's gonna pick. Oh, and no matter what you do, you can never see yourself, so even if you stood in the position to look at yourself, you can't.
Well, you've got a weird-looking hand, so we know that about you. Oh, went to the girls' bathroom?
Yes, he did, and he just exploded.
And his kidney shot out?
Yep, his kidney shot out.
Wouldn't the artificial kidney be ruined by the attempt to, like, purge all the poisons that he just ate?
That should have made sense, actually, but I guess
maybe they can, like, hose it out.
Yeah, and clean it up, but I guess the rest of his body couldn't handle it.
Just shove it. Hey, you need a kidney?
Kombawa. Return to Darlington Station. So this is where, like, the fight comes in.
There's a fight?
Yeah, technically. Oh yeah, the text broke. I was like, what was that?
Really?
Yeah, when you swat enough of the people, they stop turning into flies and they'll just like make weird faces.
Right.
Okay, there's the agent.
Hand over the wetware.
The kidney, in other words. If you leave one of the guys alive, he'll be like, please spare me.
These guys are really ineffective, holy shit.
I think that's kind of the joke.
Wait, robo homeless guy. Pissing in the alley.
Oh god, like I actually saw someone pissing like on a wall.
Never overclock your underwear. Excellent idea.
I actually saw someone like pissing on a wall like outside of a Shopper's Drug Mart, basically a convenience store, and I'm just like, wow, I wasn't expecting
well,
to
shit.
See that. So I just went by and like was like, I'm just gonna pretend I didn't see that.
What kind of shit old country is Canada anyway?
Obviously, most likely joking, but there are shit parts of it. Not every country is perfectly clean.
Yeah, I'd imagine. Like, the one guy is literally a bowling pin.
Yeah, because everyone's falling over like bowling pins.
Yeah, and they're making bowling pin noises.
Please don't hurt me. Alright.
I think you could just get out if it... So I'm guessing this is some kind of recurring thing, because you were in the koi garden before, and...
Oh, yeah.
Is this for koi fish, and now you're in some sort of temple?
Yeah, but I don't know. This is just like a transition thing, so I didn't really quite get it.
It's like you're getting like deeper and deeper into it each time.
Sort of, but not quite. And he wanted the kidney just to make a pie.
Wouldn't the thing be like metal?
That's true. Then again, this guy's probably a robot. So now we're taking a vacation. Yeah, the game's almost over. Can you believe that?
Yeah, it seems like this game is more about the background details than anything.
The intricacies of it. Oh, this part. This part's kind of funny, actually. You can actually visit all the worlds and get an achievement for it, too. So here's
prefectures of Japanada.
Japanada.
Nice.
Bad sector.
So you're just, like, kind of going close to these various major cities?
Yeah, I skip through the ones that are at least interesting enough to, like, show in this video.
Right.
But, yeah, so I could have just gone to where I was supposed to.
Where are you going?
To, Kaitak, Siberia. Oh, get it?
Right.
Oh, there's if you're a Spoonie watcher, you'd probably know one of his jokes in this. It actually pops
and
up.
Jing.
Just hang on, it's almost there.
Beyond Thunderdome, nice. Thunderdome and Beyond Thunderdome. What the who took a bite out of Australia?
Did you see that, the landfill of the Atari games?
Oh.
Anyway, that's where I'm supposed to go.
E.T. just crashed. Someone threw an E.T. cartridge too high and it just slammed down.
I'll check this out.
I am a Johnny Cab. Where would you like to go?
He crashes the car and I still give him change.
He crashes the car, somehow gets underneath it, and then... Gotta give him something.
I just find it funny. You still give him change even though he's probably gonna die.
Yeah, well, he's gonna need it for his, I don't know, funeral.
A change of parts. So we're on vacation, but obviously things don't go that well.
Oh my god, I'd love to see this on vacation.
Oh god, what was it?
Spinning blue-eyed robot.
It's one of the Star Trek, the Borg. That's what it looks like to me.
Yeah. Welcome to Borg Resort.
I didn't sign the guest book, and you don't have to, because I thought...
Comfort is irrelevant.
Oh, jeez.
Oh. Recreation is irrelevant.
I think I...
You
did
will
I,
buy...
Did I tell you something about a Street Fighter-related thing?
No.
Okay, well, I guess I must be someone else, but check this out.
Some
Honda versus Polly Blanca.
Well, this is the classic, you're beating up a...
Car.
Beating up a car thing.
But obviously the Honda thing is, E-Honda. I actually saw a movie where it was like a parody of Honda, and his name was called Toyota.
S-Toyota?
Well, it was like, go get him, Toyota! It's like, oh, I get it, because Honda... E-Honda is also like the car thing, so...
Yeah.
But obviously this is a parody of, like, the car... The punching the car, but yeah.
Yeah, for Street Fighter 2. Yeah, I've been watching a little bit of Street Fighter 5 because fighting games can be fun to watch. Or the Street Fighter 5 beta, excuse me.
Oh, okay, yeah, because it's not quite out yet. Oh yeah, there's a lot of stuff to do in this resort too. I show a few things on here, but not everything, of course.
Mm.
There's a little mini game.
After 10,000 years, I'm free. It's time to conquer.
That is the one like. Childhood
line.
nerdy thing that I never actually was able to see.
Oh, Power Rangers?
Yeah, I never interested in it.
And then we go into a Fruit Ninja parody, I assume. You get nothing for getting all perfect, by the way.
I don't know, man. Fruit Ninja was more fun than this.
Well, for a little while. I mean, like, I did download it and played it for quite a bit, but after getting most of the things, which was actually quite quick, I just stopped, because...
Well, I went to this Disney arcade in Florida, like, Disney-themed arcade, and you pay a bit, and you pay, like, $40, and you get in for free play.
Oh, like, for the entire day?
Yeah, for, like, as long as you want.
Oh, that's not bad. Until closing.
Yeah, and then, so I spent most of my time playing Fruit Ninja.
Oh.
Because they have this giant touchscreen for it.
And the novelty of it was like, oh, a giant touchscreen Fruit Ninja.
Yeah, it was awesome. I was just, they only had, like, the time attack mode, though, because, like, the 2 minutes at a time mode, because you could go on forever if you really tried.
Yeah, I'm not too sure what that binocular was quite for, so... But, yeah, there's another
binocular. Maybe if you, like, look far enough, you'll see something.
Oh, yeah, you can steal this guy's master key and go in other people's places. I tried to get him to say something like, oh, why'd you take my master key? But he didn't say it. I didn't want to waste the time.
Right.
Oh yeah, this van. You see it across, like, in several levels. They're the Agent Smiths that keep track of you.
You mean, like, the guys you knock down, like, bowling pins?
Oh, yeah, pretty much.
The agents are shit. This is like the Matrix of Agent Smith, which is like some kind of random subroutine they just found.
Or a cardboard box.
Yeah, he was actually some kind of like a counting program. And they're just like, you're in charge of the Matrix now. And then he's like,
okay.
2 + 2 = 4. Your Roth IRA will have a payout of $3,000 per month.
Okay, so remember when you were saying, like, if only this was a first-person shooter?
Oh, because is it actually going to become a first-person shooter?
Just check it.
Marriage license shooter?
Wedding Quake.
God.
So I play one game of this because this is kind of funny. And surprisingly, it's actually... It could have been a nice first-person shooter game.
You got it.
Obviously, I'm going to eventually win this, but for now...
Rage Virus? Oh, everyone just got their random names.
Yep, and the AI... Tab? And the AI is okay. I'm surprised there's no multiplayer of this, like, just for laughs.
Yeah. This is just shitty Quake, though.
Oh, it's Wedding Quake.
Yeah, it's my mistake, excuse me. Oh, so is that what you do? You just get the rocket launcher and then just kill everyone?
The Rosit launcher? Yeah, that's pretty much like, it's one kill, right? And it explodes.
Child one kill, yeah. And is everything unlimited ammo?
Yeah, pretty much. Because the infinity symbol on the bottom left.
Right, yeah, you just have to paint that on your gun and then you'll you get infinite ammo.
Or, you know,
that's what Solid 3 taught me.
I was going to say that. I was going to be like, well, if you have an ammo case that's in an infinite symbol, it will be infinite.
Your ammo drum and just make it infinite.
Yep. And I don't know why that explosion didn't kill him, so I was like, oh, I need to get out of there and get some health. Health! I need health!
That was a weird tonal thing they did in Metal Gear that I thought was always weird. Just like...
The explanation for the infinite
ammo? You'll be taking... Yeah, just like, you'll be taking, you'll be having, like, really serious moments with the boss and shit, and just like, oh, she has an infinity symbol on her gun, that means that she has infinite ammo. Like, what the fuck?
It's kind of
also protects her from harm from the front. It's like...
It's one of those silly things. It's just kind of like, that's just what Metal Gear does.
I guess.
The Metal Gear Solid series does. Now, I'm actually wasn't hitting any of those guys, so after a while, I was like, oh, I'm probably wasting my time.
It's got some kind of invisible wall thing. I would guess.
Where the bullets just didn't do shit. Like, you see the bullets going there,
yeah,
but it's not actually hitting them.
Yeah, that gun looks like shit.
It is shit.
It's like you want the Rosa launcher instead.
Yeah, and you don't want the champagne. Oh, I shot the sheep.
Oh, does he give you a heart?
Yes, he gave me a heart. He had a heart, and I didn't.
In what wedding, Dig? Are there just sheep running around?
Ah, that's a good question, but I assume they had some sort of symbolism. I don't know what happened to that that rocket there. It just disappeared.
Yeah, it didn't even explode.
So I was hoping I'd hit someone over there, if I was fortunate.
Oh, it's first to 10.
Yeah, you don't want to overstay this, because I wouldn't play this for any longer than that.
Okay, yeah. Was it Rose? What was the one guy named Rage Virus?
Rage Virus, and one of them was called Hadouken.
Nice.
Oh, and then I checked this.
Excellent.
Yeah, it's after the GoldenEye references, and well, this is pretty much all like secret agent related stuff.
He was actually in front of it.
And he broke it into pieces.
That's a good one. You see, you can't just have a reference. There has to be some kind of twist on it.
Yeah, I'd say this is like this is amusing fun in its own right. There's more stuff in this game too. Like there's a Ninja Turtle like reference too, somewhere. Oh, look, a banana phone.
Sorry, Polyblank. Change your plans.
So now we're like on vacation, like suddenly we have a mission because it's a good opportunity to switch cases with the guy.
Right. And you'll see so you're giving him like your used laundry in return for like $1 million or something?
Probably. Or some top secret data. Yeah. I think you'll find the antagonist kind of amusing because I certainly found him sort of amusing. Oh, by the way, this room you're being watched too. You'll find out later about it, though.
Yeah, I generally assume I'm always being watched when there's G-Men on site.
There, the infinity symbol will protect me.
Yeah, it'll make you infinitely sexy.
Yep, and you can actually go
trying to charm.
You can actually go around kissing everyone.
Wait. You can just jump off the roof?
Yep. I mean, you are like, in the Matrix, right?
I guess you're the, like, superior version of James Bond.
James Bond wish he could jump
off. Do you leave lipstick marks on people?
Yes. There we go.
Oh, you could... What?
Ah, yeah, I'm helping
Wait, do you still have those hairy arms when you're wearing...
Yes.
Oh, it's on her back. What a joke.
This part is kind of... Oh, man. This part is just a little bit pointless because... I've already gotten the achievement for doing all the silly shit around here, but I thought I'd show the resort off a little bit. Yeah. Water physics are pretty cool.
Do they, like, react differently if you kiss them in different spots?
That would be quite funny, because I did try that. I actually went up to this one... I can't even say person, but this, like, this one... No, well, that's the only way thing I can say. This one person, and it's like, I kissed all over... Or, I got my character to kiss all over them, and nope, nothing. Nothing. Although it would be funny, though. They'd say something like, oh, you pervert, or something on one of them where it's like...
Right.
Like, where they say something unexpected. Oh yeah, so I broke my legs there.
Is it the world of rape culture? Is that actually the story of this game?
Well, it is. It did have a very Japanese theme to it at one point.
Aha! Therein lies the root of the problem.
Yes. The Japanese. Yeah, I also got lost
just kiss this chick? It doesn't look like she has a shirt or like any kind of covering for her chest.
You're right. I didn't notice that. I guess that's why it works so well. Anyways, I got lost in this like this level the first time I was playing because I couldn't find it. Yeah, this is one of the random events where a character would like pop up and suggest you go check things out, but you don't have to.
Does he like only show up because you're a girl?
No, it's because I didn't go to the beach. If I went to the beach, he wouldn't show up.
Right.
Because I was saying earlier, like in that first level, if I went around the city, the agent would actually appear if I didn't go around the city checking stuff out. But I guess like because I went to check out that box in the first level, the agent didn't pop up because it was like, oh, he checked out the level. So apparently this is what we look like because she says we're twins.
I just love your lipstick. Where'd you get it? Who does your hair?
She doesn't say anything useful.
It's
just like
the cocktails here are amazing.
I just went up and like smooshed all over.
Huh. She doesn't even say anything in response to that. She's just used to it.
Nope, no reaction to
wonder
it.
Wonder how jaded you have to be to, like,
let people
not react
do
at all and people just kiss you.
I guess if you're, like, a robot.
Like, I guess. That's what these people tend to look like.
So there's the person we gotta meet with. We'll see who he is soon.
That swap.
I just swap it right in front of his face.
C-3PO, apparently.
The editor antagonist. The antagonist is literally
named... He's the editor?
Yeah. The antagonist is literally named the antagonist. And he had a bunch of other, like, job occupations underneath it, like kidnapping and such.
Wait, didn't it say, like, the editor?
Yeah, it did say the editor. The editor is the antagonist.
Huh. Why is his name the editor? I guess this guy, like... submitted a manuscript and had it rejected.
Oh, well, there's the director, and then he's the editor. I guess he's, like, the second of,
I guess.
Of,
right, like, the film editor. Okay, makes sense.
there's not much that, like, at the time of this video, they didn't write anything on the wiki for it when I tried looking it up, so I can't really say much about it. Yeah, that drink, you're forced to drink that, drink the lady serves you, otherwise you can't proceed with the game.
So it's a trap.
Yeah, he already knew you were under disguise.
Well, no wonder. The person you were disguised as was, like, 2 feet away.
And she's like, oh, we're twins! It's like,
in,
wait
like,
a minute.
In, plain view.
I always wanted a twin. Not one that took over my life or anything, but just like, oh, cool, I have someone that's like me.
Yeah, there's some exact other person. I don't know, I feel like I would be obligated to like go and do different things and be a different person so that I retain
unique.
My individuality.
Yeah, so like
classic slip under the door.
So we're in the room next to ours because this is the room where they were watching us.
What did that note say?
That note said, I want to help you, meet me at the rear pool."
No. Okay, so that's how they've been watching you.
Yeah, so... And all the hotel rooms have, like, stuff in it. And that's smoke signs. Instead of saying, don't smoke, it tells you to actually smoke.
Tells you smoke, Cam?
I take his card again, even though it does nothing. It's only the fourth floor that has anything interesting, because all the other floors underneath here... I haven't looked at all of them, because they all ended up being mostly the same thing, so I just, like, under the assumption and assumed it's just, like, oh, nothing different. So that's the pool where we go. I got lost trying to find the pool, because I was like, which pool are you talking about?
Right, because I thought there was another pool back there.
Yeah, yeah. And here's another VHS tape that's a Blockbuster VHS parody tape.
How do you, or what does it do to return them? You made
it. You just get an achievement for it, and it tells you something at the end, like, oh, how many tapes you've returned. So this guy's trying to help us, and I'm just dicking off, basically.
What is he saying? You need to take precautions?
Oh, yeah, because you're being watched. This is a classic spy thing.
Ah, okay, you're getting your tooth pulled.
Yep. Oh, wow. Apparently I'm holding the key on my left
side.
You
have a tooth that's half the size of your head.
I know, and it's like there's a radio on it. There's a trauma couch.
Holy. I think you would have felt that, but whatever.
Yeah, I don't know how he's like, oh, this is completely normal.
Oh, so this guy's a conspiracy theory type guy? Only this time he happens to be right?
Yeah, and he's also like one of the people that's stuck here.
It's all fake. It's software. We are all characters in a scene. You, they. It's taken me decades.
Oh, no shit, it's the Matrix. I figured that out on the first two pill popping.
Yeah, but you went in.
Find the mechanical kick, kill it and cook it. I couldn't find out where you were supposed to cook this pig until like much, much later. Oh yeah, so you take like a ukulele guitar to smash the pig.
Godspeed. This is exactly conspiracy theorist logic. Like, but you can only meet the pig with a ukulele of death.
And wearing like a salad bowl over your head.
Wait, that's the mechanical pig? It just shows up in front of you?
Yeah, it doesn't have moving legs, it's on wheels.
Oh.
So you beat it and then you cook it near a certain area. I don't know where this reference from. I assume it's from some like
I don't know what
like World of Warcraft game. Where you keep clicking something and it explodes.
Click the sheep and explode. Yeah, I have no idea.
It's from an RTS somewhere, I believe. Because I recall like a game where you keep clicking a certain item, then it just explodes. Here is the little roast pit that I didn't notice. So like when I was playing it first, my first time, like the first like for 30 minutes, I couldn't find it.
Mm-hmm.
Then we escape the Matrix and we go to our an interesting but yet boring place. Like visually, this place is kind of interesting. Like kind of like the network of it.
This is like anti-chamber.
Oh yeah, it does look like it. By the way,
I never played that game though.
By the way, that moth there, I mean, did you get it? There's a bug in the system.
Right, yeah, it's clogging up the gears.
I forget who this guy was a reference to, but it was like... Nah, I forget. I forget who it was, but I'll probably put text saying like, oh, this guy's a reference to a certain somebody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so
we
just...
This is exactly like Punch Club, you just references.
Yeah, I find this part quite weak. Like, it's just like nothing really gets in your way, and it's not too funny compared to the rest of the game.
And plus, like, you know, it doesn't seem to have like the same free roaming aspect.
Nope, or at least, you know, exploration. It's very, very straightforward.
Oh, you just won solitaire. Nice.
Yeah, and you know how when you win solitaire, the cards come
flying
out?
Yeah, the cards fall down.
This one is one of the few funnier things in the game. If you read, it actually has a few other things written on the blue screen of death.
Are they hanging a fishing pole down here?
Yeah, that was one funny thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I just went immediately for the exit, because you could explore a little bit, but it's very, very limited.
Yeah, I can see how this game would be worth getting for like random exploration, but I'm starting to sour on the sort of indie self-aware kind of thing. It seems like every other game is just like have tons of references to stuff and like
to be ironic.
Yeah, ironic, just like breaking the fourth wall all over the place. And it's like, you know, you can just make a story if you want. Like,
yeah,
you don't have to.
Like, it's fine, but it's just kind of like everyone's been doing it. It's kind of like lost its uniqueness. So how do you be ironic about being ironic?
Yeah, you don't.
So we get back to base, and then we find out a few things have happened. Oh, look, it's the secretary. Oh, no, it's
she
not
has a cardboard cutout.
She's not the secretary, because she's been captured. She had a stand-in.
Right.
And the magazines here changed.
Did they change to something weirder?
No. Well, I guess yes, but not really. So the antagonist, Oh, I like this part. You're probably right. It appears I'm in the process of being kidnapped.
You'll find him in the castle of
Yeah, so he's been captured and we gotta go rescue him. This is the final mission. Oh yeah, she dropped in. Oh, here's a classic spy thing. Soon at the end, I think you'll... Yeah, there we go.
I just lit on fire instead of exploding.
Yeah, it doesn't actually explode. And I didn't take any... And, like, Polyblank didn't take any pills.
Right, so maybe that was a dream, and your other things were a dream within a dream.
Very complex. Anyway, so we're at... So we go to the guy's apartment. Okay, yeah, so I was just doing something off-screen there for a bit. We come disguised as an exterminator, as this robot points out. This robot butler, who's not like the butler from Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Or the butler from Fallout. I'm your new robot butler, Wadsworth. You know, I had this moment when I was a female character playing Fallout 3, where... It's like, I am your new robo-butler, Wadsworth. Right? And
my humor
emitter
ray needs recharging. Oh, that's a good joke.
But yeah, no, what happened was, he was like, I am here to look after your needs and keep you happy and entertained. But I was too close to him, so my character ended up looking down to this, like, weird claw thing that he had. So he was like, I am here to keep you happy and entertained. I'm like, my character's female. What are you implying? You're going to keep me happy and entertained with that little claw thing.
What are you trying to do?
I'm like, I don't like where this is going.
So yeah, I debugged the system, which is kind of funny the way they went about it.
And you shot toast in this guy's face?
Yeah, because this guy starts demanding food from me. Because I actually did this thing before I talked to him.
Oh.
And I was like, oh, well, I'm sorry. Yeah, so then, like, the next time I played during the recording, I talked to him, and he was like, oh, this guy's an asshole. So I was like, okay, I'll throw this shit at you.
How's my breath?
So I explored the mansion a little bit. This place is pretty entertaining in a way.
There's more Agent Smith. You can help them with their daily routine.
Oh, and check this out. Jeez, I wonder what the reference is.
To basketball.
It's a reference to Psycho.
Yeah, Psycho.
Oh, and this part. This took me a little bit to, like, get it, to understand the joke, but...
You're just picking the nose?
No, you know lock picking, and then there's nose picking.
Right.
So it was like, oh, I get it. Okay, yeah, that's kind of...
Wait, was there just a bunch of water in that drawer?
Yeah, there was. It's a stew. I don't get the significance of that. Yeah, apparently I thought this room was a special room, so I didn't find it the first time. There she goes!
Yeah, that happened the last time I had a pillow fight.
Man, what... Those pillows, they're made of hard, durable material. They're not light. Guess. They're not to be taken lightly to the face.
Got hyperkinetic gel on them.
Oh yeah, so you gotta play with this this lady for a bit.
Can you keep clipping after they're done clipped?
No. Yeah, they didn't go into that detail. It would've been kind of weird if you could clip off their toes.
You could like clip off her toe.
I was trying to trigger the Oh yeah, so I didn't give a shit here, so I just painted everything.
Yeah.
Which was not a good idea because I couldn't tell where the toenails were at a certain
right.
point.
Yeah, you just have to keep.
Yeah, like right
flaring
there.
Around.
And neon the carpet's blue. Dirty too.
Neon blue nail polish. Interesting.
So basically, I'm messing around with this lady because it's to trigger the director to pop up.
Promiscuous polynomials.
Oh yeah, you can become a DJ. Look at that ring.
Excellent.
Excellent.
I have to wonder what that's a reference to.
I don't know what the reference are. I guess it was just like, oh, Polly Blank is also a DJ.
Promiscuous polynomials. Some kind of like math thing. What is an EKG on the screen?
So right here, I'm still trying to trigger the director to pop up. I don't remember what I was doing wrong.
Is it like a sort of Just Cause thing where like you make enough trouble and then he just shows up?
Something like that. I'm actually not sure how to actually trigger him. So I just went around like and dicked around
just
in the
like
condo
doing stuff. Yeah.
Cause like every time I played it, at least before like this third recording, I just went to this room and then just. He would pop up after I, like, talked with this lady. Huh. But he does eventually pop up soon enough. After I, dicked
yeah,
around
I guess,
a little more.
Are you sure it's not this lady you're supposed to be messing with? There's two people.
I'm getting kissed by hobo. No.
Now I know what my nightmares are going to be about tonight.
Oh, see, now the director pops up. God.
So, see the editor or the director?
Or the director. Did I say editor? I meant director.
No, okay. Oh, that guy.
Dramatic camera.
Over here, Polly Blank.
I don't know what he said.
No, over here. No.
Wait,
but obviously.
A bit more.
No, like, you know the dramatic, like, turn around and look at it? Look
yeah,
at, like,
and then it's just not there.
And it's the wrong one.
Go back
oh.
Back a bit.
And he was, like, trying to help you adjust.
Stop.
Yeah, I'm cradling this baseball bat.
Ah, Polly Blank.
Okay. So now they're on topic, and,
You've taken something of mine, and so I've
we gotta beat. We're trying to free the director, so we gotta play a game with the editor. Which, at first I thought you can't win. You were saying?
Some of our important directors.
Such as himself.
Right.
Because he was the only director.
I challenge you to a game of sport. Should you prove victorious?
Baseball?
Oh, don't worry. It doesn't matter what he'll get, because you'll see what he'll do.
There won't be one hint of foul play.
Baseball? Golf? Oh.
He's a cheating son of a bitch. I swear you can't beat this game like tie with him, because I found out later on in this playthrough actually that you can actually beat like the editor at some of the games. It wouldn't change it doesn't change anything except for some dialogue.
Right.
But like this first golf game I couldn't get a hole in one on any of them.
So is there actual like golf physics to this?
To a degree, yes. Actually, it's more like pool, because I'm using a pool cue. Yes, we're accusing you of foul play. I try to see if I can mess with his machine, but you can't do it.
Shouldn't you be golfing?
That's not exactly a perfect argument. I've never lost. What do you mean I'm cheating?
I mean, the only way you could have never lost is if you were cheating. Either that or you were God.
You're just really good.
Oh yeah, this part is really annoying to control with the controller, so...
Yeah, it looks like it is.
At this point, I used the mouse, which was much, much better. Because if I used the controller, this would have taken me, like, 5 more minutes just to, like, adjust.
Just to, like, try and adjust everything, yeah.
Also, the assistant got jellied in there. You rescue her later. You don't
what
have
What is to, everything you can eat?
The jelly?
Yeah.
This was...
What?
Shaving a hedgerow.
With your Edward Scissorhands?
Oh! I didn't get... Oh, that's interesting. I didn't think of that. So here I'm trying to calculate to get a hole-in-one. I'm pretty sure you can get a hole-in-one in this one.
Yeah, it looks possible.
But I obviously fucked it up. And
so
I realized
can
I wasn't...
Can you, like, just take out anything you have?
And
is it like a weapon system? Like
Yeah, kind of. You switch items with the Y button on a controller. I don't know what it is on the keyboard though. I don't remember if it was this run through where I caused a glitch in the game or in the previous one, but I'm pretty sure it's this one. I caused the glitch with the soccer ball here. Yeah, it turned into a soccer ball. How's that?
I'm waiting. Oh.
That happened.
Oh.
That's not supposed to happen, but I broke the game.
Wait, what?
I broke the game.
Excellent. Also, it's supposed to be a soccer ball.
Most excellent breakage of the game. Eventually, I did manage to...
Can you shoot down?
No, you can't. Because whatever plane it's on, it shoots straight forward. So eventually, I fixed it. So if, like, the creators are watching
curious
this,
to see
like,
how.
I broke your game.
Yes, excuse me about that one.
So I shot it at him, and it bounced off of him, and the physics, like, kicked back in. I don't know how I even made it, like, bounce so hard it flew up.
Yeah, I did. I don't get it. I think it might have hit the side too hard.
Like, that's weird. Anyway, so that game went to him because he obviously beat that fair and square, so we're off to the next course. Which, funny enough, I actually beat him at the next two games. Not so much the third game, but the second one is a race. And I was surprised I was actually able to beat him. Oh,
Superman 64.
I was going to say, Superman 64.
You know, I rented that game when I was a kid.
I actually got really far in that game, by the way. Like,
yeah, you know, I was like really stupid when I was a kid, so I didn't get far in any games.
Well, see, and Superman 64 is an exception because it is really shitty.
Well, with Superman 64, I actually never got past like the rings even. I didn't really do anything in the game.
Get some nuts, chips, and batteries. It took me just a little while to kind of get the joke there.
So were you a robot too?
No, like you know the nuts and bolts, like those are nuts, and the chips are chips.
Right. What are the batteries?
I don't know. That's the thing that I didn't get. So we were playing Mary Had a Little Lamb with like Russian roulette. I didn't get that. And here's a Star Trek thing with
Oh, it's Uhura.
Yeah.
You know, that was the first interracial kiss on television, apparently, between Kirk and Uhura.
Oh, really?
In Star Trek.
Oh, but yeah, that's true. I forgot about that.
Not that I actually know anything about Star Trek other than that.
I've never seen Star Trek. I was more of a Star Wars person. Anyway, so we're playing a gravy race, and this might look like a certain something. Wave Race 64.
Excellent.
So we're racing in those cups.
How?
I don't know. It's the Matrix. But anyways, I was actually surprised, because every time from the times I've played this, I've always lost to this guy to second place. But this time, I actually did get in first place.
This is how you make an indie game. You just get high, and then just, like, say what comes into your brain, and then just, like...
You know, that's true.
And then they race on a pool of gravy with two ladles. Swap.
Are they called ladles? And they'd be a parody of, Wave Race 64.
Yeah, and then just throw in, like...
And somehow this gets passed, and people are like, oh, it's so quirky, it's called being high.
Yeah, more or less.
Yeah, so at this point, I was like, oh, I'm probably going to lose.
This game is interesting.
It's actually fun. I kind of wish there were more tracks for this.
And it just seems like one of those, it just seems like one of those games that people don't like, where it's like, just walk around, do stuff game.
That right there, like, I can't believe I won. First place, look at this dialogue.
Yeah, it doesn't look like he's actually that fast.
You're not supposed to be able to win this, but you did.
Nice.
I was so surprised. That last jump boost, like, gave me the edge.
These aren't even like, these don't even look like they were digitally generated. They just look like little life preservers that have like really thin.
Because of the coloring, right?
Yeah, that have like really thin rings.
All right, so I fuck around a little here. So this part's kind of, I find it funny.
All right, nice.
I found that funny. It was like
that sounds.
The robot can't aim.
That feels painful.
Yes, it is. Oh, look, the virtual boy. Look, the power glove.
Did it have gloves?
No, that's the power glove. Oh, you're gonna love how I end this, because I actually found out later on my second try, on the first recording, that I could actually do this. You can actually play a legit game with this guy, but, to save time after I score, you can actually score against the guy, but it's really hard. So grab the chair. People are watching. And just beat the shit out of him and you win.
Champion. And this is in a video game.
Reverse winning. I didn't lose, it's called reverse winning.
I love how he's like, oh, that was completely legit. Yeah. Just walked over and hit me with a chair. Why didn't I think of that? Obviously he beat me. Fairly.
And so now I gotta find trophies for him because he's egotistical. Or should I say ego-testicle?
He's miss something?
Oh, I didn't notice that. So I guess he is a bitch. So there's like the crown, there's the world belt. Yes, a world wrestling belt.
Oh, hey, so there she is.
One of those, it's just business, and then I don't remember if I did something to them. I think I probably did.
No one knows what it's like to be in a video game.
So check this out.
Oh my god.
Man, would you have fun while you're being liquefied?
Did you genocide?
Yes, I did.
One of the buttons is genocide?
By the way, that lady's fat.
Okay, here.
I have those eyeballs.
Oh my god.
And she's like, the drink is so good. I didn't see how it was made, so it just made it much funnier. Hand me my trophy.
Miss
Japanada?
It's Japanada, okay.
Okay. Okay, and then at this point, I start dicking around near the end, so I actually played a game with this. This character, because I was
smack her with a chair as well.
I wanted to do that,
but there's no chairs.
No, you can't go past the net. It wouldn't let you. So I tried to lose as quickly as possible.
Virtual girl, and obvious. This is virtual tennis. I love how you go to a tennis court and they play a virtual game of it. Instead of buying a tennis racket and a tennis ball, they just decide to buy two virtual ones. Isn't this more expensive? I can't believe I actually scored that. I was like, oh. And you're trying to lose. Yeah, I'm trying to lose because once I realized I couldn't like just jump up and punch her in the face. I was just like, oh goddamn, I'm wasting time. It's like the first 5 wins will get you will end the game. Oh yeah, first to 5. But you can win against her. I've done it before, but it was just like for time's sake.
I'm pretty sure that's an illegal move you just did.
Yep, but this is a video game.
And yeah, that was like solidly inside you, and you still smacked it back.
It was my balls. Wait, I still got that.
Wait, what? I'm pretty sure she must have hit it out then.
Most intriguing. I don't know why I didn't just aim to the side and just be like, oh, fuck it.
Yeah, you should just let it go.
Like, right here. And then I think one more round, and then that would be it.
Yeah, you're sitting here like, she's gonna beat me, but you know.
I don't know. And then she makes me score again. I'm like, what the fuck, lady? I think at some point when she scored enough, I was like, okay, you know what, fuck it, I'm gonna win this, and then I didn't.
Oh.
Because it was one of those, like, oh, I got this far, but, oh, look, see, she helped me score again, so I was like, okay, fine, I'm gonna fight you for real.
Yeah, I think I'm pretty sure all of your successes have been triggering that.
Yep, and then game over.
Yeah, fucked up. The last shot that would have won it all.
I'm super good at this.
Yeah,
I'm
all
super
right,
good
lady.
At this for scoring for me. I was trying to lose and she got me most of those scores. Same to director, same.
Yeah, you're the best player the opposing team ever had.
Funny and sad.
Flying dumpsters?
Flying toasters. Because earlier I was shooting toasters at these ducks. I wanted to see what happened if I didn't save the lady or the assistant, but I decided to do it anyways. Afterwards. Yeah, I noticed that the tank, you can actually do something with it. So I was like, ooh, let's show this off a little bit.
Take the crab back.
So I wasn't sure what the joke was here, like other than it being a crane game. I thought the whole joke was to release the toxin or whatever into the tank and then that'd be it.
I want the crab. The crab looks like a fun guy.
Hope he's not too crabby.
Probably hang around with him.
Oh, he'd be walking sideways all the time. I tried to grab the seahorse, but it didn't work. Yeah, I waste a tremendous amount of time in this.
What you just said there reminded me that when I did PE in elementary school, they would have us do the crab walk.
Oh god.
Where we would walk backwards. I'm like, that's not right. Crabs don't walk backwards.
They walk sideways.
Yeah, they walk sideways. They shuffle. They like sure shuffle along.
They do the MC Hammer dance. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Can't touch this.
Now, I want to see a crab with baggy pants.
Oh god, MC Crabber.
Absolutely. Okay, in one of my college classes earlier, we were shown a clip of MC Nuts, N-U-T-Z, and he was a rapper, and he was in a squirrel suit, and he was doing a rap rendition of a poem by William Wordsworth.
MC Nuts.
Yes, MC Nuts.
So, as you can see, I'm trying to grab the sea urchin, and I'm just failing miserably.
Are you trying to, like, pile them up?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know, I thought something might happen if I put them all near the toxic, container.
So, can you, like, get any of them out of the tank?
I think you might be able to, I don't know. I don't know what that reference is. If anyone can tell me what, like, the joke for that is, I'd appreciate it.
I think it's just something you can do in the background.
Yeah.
Crocification? Why did you do that? Oh, Gatorizer.
Because they both did the same thing anyways.
Yeah.
I was so disappointed. This is the ending to this game. You just get eaten by the director.
Damn.
And I'm just like, well, why'd you give us two choices? Oh, because it's quirky. It's like, oh, fuck off.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I decided to save the secretary, which takes 26 hours to do.
Like, I was just obviously a post-it note over what was supposed to be there.
I know. I can't believe I actually fell for it. I thought it was like an actual ending, or at least, you know, he transforms into something else to eat me.
I think you're better off being eaten, honestly. If you just spent 26 hours eating Jell-O, you'd really not want to see what comes out of that.
I don't even know why I would want to be eaten. I was trying to see if I can grab the remote to like shock him, which probably wouldn't do anything though. I try to talk to him and like see if there was some different ending I can do, but apparently the only way to end this game is to just get eaten.
Huh.
Oh, and it turns very System Shock 2 at the end of this.
Oh shit, really?
Like, you know, I got reminded of, like, when you're in the final parts of System Shock in the flesh. What was that level called? The Womb or whatever?
Yeah, it was the Womb. It was, I don't remember. It was just called the Body of the Many.
Yeah, that was it. The Body of the Many. Which this pretty much looks like it, too.
Remember we got there in co-op and then you just left me behind?
Yes, I did. You always gotta bring that up, even though you beat the game before me, though.
Yeah. So wait, there's just shit growing inside of him.
Yeah, because, I don't know, vegetation? I guess he's a vegetarian?
I feel like you have to be in the right frame of mind to appreciate these kinds of games, but this is just like six levels deep of just nonsense, and
well,
I can't take it seriously. Like, Sandra Bullock? What?
Yes, yeah, Sandra Bullock was something like, I actually read the credits at some point, but I just kind of skimped through all of
them. Sandra Bullocks. I bet that was actually the joke.
Yep, so this is the game, Jazz Punk. I mean, I enjoyed the game, but it's obviously a one-time playthrough kind of deal.
Yeah.
Because this ending sucks, I'm just going to say. But otherwise, I did find the game very quirky. And it is short, maybe a little too short, but you know I'm fine with it.
Okay, so you get to go in another Matrix.
Yes, for the credits.
Wait, and it's just
that's
the
it?
Credits again.
Yeah, I was like, why did you show the credits again? I thought that was the
they
credits.
Already... Oh, those were joke credits, I guess.
For the most part. William
Camera Defoe. Operator, the player.
Which is true.
Zoe Quinn and Jim Sterling. Interesting.
I don't know which one he voiced in here.
Yeah, I have no idea either.
I
couldn't tell. I don't really watch.
Me neither.
Shot on location in Whale Carcass, Virginia.
Oh, God. Yeah, because Jim Sterling, it's like... I don't know. When I look at him, I get the feeling it's just like... The whole, like... tries too hard to be clever and original.
Yeah, the whole cynical Brit thing is probably like
so overdone.
Yeah, it's really overplayed.
Yeah, it's just like, oh, fuck it.
Hey, look at me, I'm so... People that describe themselves as snarky are just very, very, very irritating.
Yes, they are. Like, it's just... You don't have to announce it, just be what you are.
I'd prefer people that were, like... I'd prefer more modest, genuine.
Yeah, yeah, I prefer things, more even genuine, if they, like, more modest people.
Even if they didn't have the same wit, quote-unquote.
Yeah, but yeah, so that's Jazz Punk, and that was played by me, Wizwar 100.
Well, that really petered out.
And let's see, co-commentary with Hitman. Yes. Alright, so next game we'd be commentating and talking over while you listen and watch is probably going to be Punch Club, as Hitman told me.
Some other game that Xenoclash involves punching.
You punch Come people on. In Xenoclash, right?
Yeah, those are my two ideas.
Yeah, so, you're going to have to wait a couple of months for that to happen. Not to say anything on that.
Next, 4 years, you'll see those.
Yeah, I mean, it took me, a couple of months, almost to a year, to, find the game to play for us to commentate over. We should really broaden our horizon of games. Well, I should, anyways, because I kept wanting to limit it to, a certain time frame.
Yeah, well, I have a bunch of games on Steam I haven't even played yet, so...
Yeah, and this
probably just,
us...
dip into those a bit.
Yeah, and this gives us the opportunity to either finish or play games we haven't played, much like Jazz Punk.
But, absolutely.
So what did you think of Jazz Punk?
I think I just described it when we were going through the alligator's digestive system, and I'm not sure that was a sentence that should ever have been said by a human. But, yeah... It's kind of neat. I mean, I'd have to play it myself, probably.
And
but...
look at all the other extra stuff you can do in the game that I didn't show. So, you know, I didn't show everything in this game.
Yeah, it's got the current sort of indie syndrome of, let's have references to everything and break the fourth wall all the time and have, this nonsensical acid trip storyline. It's just... They sort of lose their identity, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, I do.
Lost in the sea of...
Because, especially, when I was getting out of the Matrix, that part, it felt like they just ran out of ideas. Okay, that's kind of funny for, 2 seconds.
I feel like references can, make your world a bit funnier, but you have to make them a bit more sparse than that.
You have to give your own take on it. You were laughing at the James Bond thing where he fell off because he was actually in front of it.
Yeah, that's how you do it well, but I feel like this, there's too much. It's too, condensed in this game.
It's too based around it. But it is themed around the secret agent undercover person kind of thing, so it would be based around stuff like that.
Yeah, no. So, overall, I guess it's okay.
Yeah, it's okay.
I guess buy it to see what's going on.
I would definitely say check it out if you can. As for actually, buying it, you could have probably spent it on some other game. I mean, hey, I beat this within, an hour, so...
Yeah, you're not getting much.
You're not getting much for it.
Much bang for your buck, if you will.
Not getting much bang for your buck. I did buy this on a Humble Bundle, probably for $1 or something.
Made out pretty well then.
Yeah. So if you can get this game really really cheap, for $1 or $2, and yeah, I'd say go check it out. It's pretty fun.
Yeah, the final review. So, I guess that's it for us.
Yeah, stay tuned
for
more.
Next. Stay tuned for more.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd probably cut it after that.